You are surrounded by a community of people who have helped you arrive at this sacred place and on this sacred day.
Today, when I look my students in the eyes, all I see are constellations. If you take the time to connect the dots, you can plot the true shape of their genius, shining in their darkest hour. I look each of my students in the eyes and see the same light that aligned Orion's belt in the pyramids of Giza.
Right now, when people are scared, it's easy to be cynical and say, let me just look out for myself, or my family, or people who look or think or pray like me. But if we're gonna get through these difficult times, if we're gonna create a world where everybody has opportunity to find a job and afford college, if we're gonna save the environment and defeat future pandemics, then we're gonna have to do it together.
In service to life, and you will speak up, you will show up, you will stand up, you will sit in, you will volunteer, you will vote, you will shout out, you will help, you will lend a hand, you will offer your talent and your kindness however you can, and you will radically transform.
Most importantly, building your community is how you change the world. Unfortunately, the system does not solve the real problem. Education, violence, racism. It must be solved in the street. Class of 2020, I know the last thing you want to hear right now is stay home. It's not my message to you. My message is stay close to home. Maybe not physically, but in every other way possible. Pursue every ambition. Go as far as you possibly can dream and be the first generation to embrace a new responsibility, a responsibility to rebuild your community.
Because beliefs are our anchors. If they aren't, we run the risk of opportunism. Making choices because others do so, not because we should. But those anchors should never weigh us down. They shouldn't weigh down our capacity for thoughtful engagement and reasonable compromise.
In the words of the great philosopher of our day, Pulitzer Prize winner Kendrick Lamar, sit down, be humble.
But graduates, let me tell you, you should never ever be embarrassed by those struggles. You should never view your challenges as a disadvantage. Instead, it's important for you to understand that your experience facing and overcoming adversity is actually one of your biggest advantages. And I know that because I've seen it myself.
I see optimism. I see hope. I see the future. I know that each and every one of you has the opportunity to help someone else. All you need to do is help one person, expecting nothing in return. To me, that is a humanitarian.
Living up to your heroes is amazing, but it's not good enough. The difference between goodness and greatness is going beyond. We have to push forward and surpass their greatness in order to pay homage to their struggle. Don't be afraid.
Got plenty of work to do. But as complicated and sometimes intractable as these challenges may seem, the truth is that your generation is better positioned than any before you to meet those challenges. Flip the script. Now, how you do that, how you meet these challenges, how you bring about change, will ultimately be up to you.
Believing in You by Catherine Pulsifer. Never stop believing in you. When others doubt you, do what you love to do. No one knows better than you.
Life is too short to live others' dreams. Follow your own dream, push yourself to reach your goals, and live the life you once dreamed.
Trust your instincts, be true to yourself. You know what is right for you, never give up or give in.
Forget the words, I don't know. You can do, you can learn, you can research, you can be.
Your mind is powerful. When you believe you can, you will find a way. You won't waste a day.
Persist and persevere, do not fear. Because if you believe in you, you will find dreams can come true.
May all of your dreams turn into goals. Believe in yourself.
And remember, all of life is a choice. The decision is up to you. Believe in yourself. Dare to be whatever you want to be.
Congratulations to the Eliot Hine 2020 8th grade class. The global pandemic COVID-19 has made 2020 a year that will forever be remembered around the world. And for you, that means an unforgettable 8th grade year. Perhaps it wasn't unforgettable in the way you thought it would be. It's understandable that you may feel a sense of loss. Certainly, you didn't anticipate ending your 8th grade year without the typical celebrations that come with promotion to high school. Perhaps you're sad or angry that you didn't have these final months with your friends and your teachers before heading off to different high schools next year. Maybe you're proud of your achievements and so ready for high school that you're choosing only to focus on what lies ahead. Unique experiences and challenges present opportunities to grow. This unique school year, with whatever challenges you had to overcome, is a defining step along your amazing life journey. You are such a special group of students. In only 2 years, I've watched you grow so much. You have ideas for how to make things better for those people around you. You're confident enough to say what you want and what you need. You're funny and stylish and really great friends to one another. I'm grateful to have had a chance to get to know you. As you head to high school and begin your next chapter, carry with you what you learned, the people you met, and the experiences you had. In addition to the values you personally hold most dear, I hope that the values of Eliot Hine can also guide you along the way. Excellence. Work hard and you will continually improve. Block out anyone who says you can't. Responsibility. Take ownership of your choices and always follow through. Your work products are an extension of you. Integrity. Be true to yourself. Do what you say and say what you do. Trusting yourself and gaining the trust of those around you gets you further than just about anything else in this world. Community. Surround yourself with positive people who will support you unconditionally. This is what you will need, and it's what you deserve. As you go forward, I do not wish you luck because it's not luck that you need. I wish you good health, hard work, and smart choices, both in and outside of school. Life is not what happens to you, it's what you choose to do with what happens. So, as you head to high school, make bold choices for yourself and watch great things happen. I'm wishing you the very best for years to come. Again, congratulations.
Hello everybody joining us today. My name is Sumaya Muley and I am the co-valedictorian this year. The past 3 years have been nice with you and I want you all to remember what we have done and learned forever. We all have a lot waiting for us in the future, like high school, meeting new people, college, and more. But remember, this is just the beginning. I want to thank everyone who made this the best middle school experience for me and my classmates. This year didn't end the way we thought it would, but that didn't stop us from completing our goals. I wish you all the best of luck in high school. We got this. Go Eagles.
Always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be enough. Chanel Adams, attending Eastern High School. Asaria Addison, attending Eastern High School. Markayla Bailey, attending Richard Wright PCS for Journalism and Media Arts. Raekwon Bazemore, attending Washington Leadership Academy PCS. Rayshawn Bazemore, attending Washington Leadership Academy PCS. Kashmir Blake, attending Friendship PCS Collegiate Academy. Kaylin Blakeney, attending Eastern High School. Benny Blocker III, attending H.D. Woodson High School. Michaela Bowler, attending Eastern High School. Junius Brown, attending Eastern High School. Daryl Burroughs Brown, Lewis Coney, attending Eastern High School. Rihanna Cooper, attending Eastern High School. Naomi Cox, attending Phelps ACE High School. Takira Crossland, attending Eastern High School. Naima Dixon, attending Washington Leadership Academy Public Charter High School. Savon Dye, attending Eastern High School. Orlando Edwards, attending Eastern High School. Cecilia Fleet, attending Bard High School Early College DC. Belva Fonku, attending Dunbar High School. Kyra Ford, attending Friendship PCS Collegiate Academy. Lorenzo Freeman, attending Cesar Chavez PCS Parkside High School. DeMarco French, attending School Without Walls High School. Marquette Galloway, attending Cesar Chavez PCS Parkside High School. Malik Garrett, attending Eastern High School. Isaiah Gatling, attending Washington Leadership Academy Public Charter High School. Anthony Gerald Jr. Attending Ron Brown College Prep High School. Tristan Gross. Attending Roosevelt High School. Jabari Hall. Attending H.D. Woodson High School. Unique Hargrove. Attending Dunbar High School. Akila Harley. Attending Eastern High School. Capri Hawkins. Attending Seed Public Charter School. Kristen Herndon. Attending Washington Leadership Academy, PCS. Zariah Holton. Attending Eastern High School. DeMonte Jones. Attending Eastern High School. Assad Jones. Attending Roosevelt High School. Achilles Jones. Attending H.D. Woodson High School. Antoine Lewis. Attending Phelps ACE High School. Arnando Little. Attending Kipp College Prep High School. Carlito Lopez. Attending Eastern High School. Michael Madden. Attending Eastern High School. Damari Marshall. Attending Wilson High School. Tyreek Miller. Attending Ron Brown College Prep High School. Aaliyah Mamiko. Attending Washington Leadership Academy, PCS. Dominique Montgomery. Attending Friendship PCS Collegiate Academy. John Moore IV. Attending Roosevelt High School. Sumaya Mui. Attending McKinley Technology High School. Brianna Neal. Attending Dunbar High School. Randy Norris. Attending Eastern High School. Laurel Pannell. Attending Eastern High School. Erica Rivers. Attending Friendship PCS Collegiate Academy. Kalise Ross. Attending Eastern High School. Apriya Thompson. Attending Eastern High School. Kamari Venable. Attending Ron Brown College Prep High School. Lillian Washington. Attending Friendship PCS Collegiate Academy. Naja West. Attending Friendship PCS Collegiate Academy. Keijon White. Attending Dunbar High School. Naya Williams. Attending Washington Leadership Academy PCS. Raekwon Womack. Attending Roosevelt High School. Jewel Woodland.
National Baccalaureate Middle Years Program, Community Project, is a project completed by all students in their eighth grade year. The project is intended for students to complete self-directed inquiry in a global context, generate new insights, gain deeper understandings, appreciate the process of learning, and take pride in their accomplishments. This year, we had to amend the process some. And as a result of the global pandemic and learning from home, not all of our students were able to complete the community project. However, we had a number of students who buckled down and made sure that they got the work done. We'd like to recognize those students now. The students who completed the community project are job to all of you.
Greetings, rising ninth graders. I am so excited to be sending you this message. I have not seen any of you in person since March 13th, and I will admit a secret that I have not told anyone. I have actually missed you. While this time at home started as a nice break from the norm, I know that it has been difficult for some of you, and of course, this is not the way we anticipated ending the school year and celebrating the accomplishments that you've made throughout middle school. But honestly, we now know for sure that you all are amazing. You have indeed proven what we already knew, that when faced with hardship and challenge, you all have the grit and stamina and grace to pull through. As you enter your first year of high school and transition into the afterlife of COVID-19, do not forget this moment. You found a new level of responsibility and maturity during the quarantine, and if you allow it, it will serve you very well. I send you onward with three things to remember. First of all, I want you to remember that you are more than your circumstances. Even if the world comes to a stop, pause, or national pandemic, you can find a way to be successful. The second thing, I want you to remember, speaking slowly on purpose, do your work and ask questions. Be it virtual or in person, you must do your work and ask for and accept help in order to be successful in high school and beyond. Many of you built stronger relationships with your teachers and your peers as you realized during this time that you work better when you work with others. Never be ashamed to do what you need to do to get your work done. Do your work. And lastly, and most of you have heard me say this before, mind your business. Over the course of the next 4 years, it is your business to become a person with options. Be sure you are serving your community, that you are being a person that adults and your peers want to engage with, and that you are knowledgeable enough to articulate and share your interests with the world. If you are not minding your business, you must be minding somebody else's. And we all know, ain't nobody got time for that. Lastly, congratulations on your promotion from middle school to high school. Come back and see the new building. Encourage the rising seventh and eighth graders to do their very best as well. Continue to read and journal your thoughts over the summer as you prepare for ninth grade. But most of all, love yourselves and appreciate and love those who are closest to you. Congratulations, class of 2020. Stay safe and be great.
Greetings, scholars, parents and family members, Principal Magrino, and thank you, Eliot Hine staff. I am Andrea Carruthers, the Instructional Superintendent for Cluster 7 and Eliot Hine Middle School. Scholars, on behalf of DC Public Schools, I am proud of your 8th grade achievements thus far and encourage you to continue to strive for greatness. Congratulations, 8th graders. Remember, continue to dream and continue to soar.
Hi, everybody. I'm Kenny Lattimore, and I am really excited to be here to congratulate the class of 2020. I'm so glad that the Eliot Hine Network is broadcasting this virtual graduation for you because you deserve it. I'm here with your friends and family and your teachers to say that this is the time for you to shine. You're going to another level and you're our future. So we're looking for you to do great things to change our world. We need you. We're proud of you. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Hi, everyone. It's Sanjay here.
Hi, everyone. I'm Star.
Hi, everyone. This is Sky.
And we would like to say congratulations to the graduating students of 8th grade. Yay! Some of you may be a little nervous going into your freshman year, and that is okay. And some of you are super excited and can't wait. I know I was. I was a mixture of both.
You have had 3 years of middle school. Now you're finna take on your 4 years in high school. Please cherish those moments because you will be looking forward to homecoming, prom, parent rallies, and more. So please just cherish them.
These next 4 years are going to be full of memories. You definitely want to learn new things, meet new people, and accomplish so much more. Keep your grades and your GPA up. You can do it.
Congratulations again.
Good afternoon, my rising ninth graders. Actually, by the time you listen to this, you will be ninth graders. So, good afternoon, ninth graders. How are you? The reason I'm wearing the mask, because the next time you look at this, years from now, when I'm probably long gone, and you can remember and show your children or grandchildren of the time that you persevered when you were promoted from middle school. I am so excited. I'm so happy for what you're getting ready to become. As you go to your different high schools around the city, or even if you're going to somewhere else in the DMV, you are going to do great things. Remember all the lessons that you've learned, especially about community. Remember how you persevered during this particular time. It wasn't an easy time getting up, but the fact that you did it, and even if you didn't do it, many of you turned in assignments, and we're just so thankful for you. It was a privilege to be your grade level team lead for the eighth grade. And so I just can't wait to see what's in store for you in this next journey. Continue, make sure you just do your best. Continue to make your parents proud, but make your teachers proud, but most of all, make yourselves proud. Thank you so very much for just being the best and continuing on to do even greater things. I'm looking forward to seeing you on the basketball court when I go to the bank. Some of you are going to be tellers. Some of you are going to be artists, hockey players, swimmers, whatever. Maybe some, I'll say I taught her or him in middle school. So I'm just so excited. That's why I keep thinking about high school, because I think you're already there already. And you will be. So do well. I have to give a special shout out, Africa, to Senegal. Because that was my woo-woo group. So I love you dearly. Continue to do your best. And you'll see me somewhere around the DMV. Take care. And again, God bless.
Oh my God, the babies are no more babies. Congratulations, class of 2020. You guys made it. You are finally in high school. I am so proud of you. I just want to say thank you for accepting me as one of the new behavior technicians this year. You guys have been amazing, even though it's been hard some days, really, really hard some days. You guys drove me crazy, but I love you, and you guys taught me so much. I've grown because of you. I've seen you guys grow. All the hard work you guys put in since day one is finally paying off. Remember our core values: excellence, responsibility, integrity, and community. Please take those values everywhere you go in life, and I know you guys will do amazing. You guys will succeed in high school. If you need anything, and I mean anything, feel free to always reach out to me. There's always a home at Eliot for you guys. I will always be here for you guys. I love you, and congrats.
Hey, 8th grade, congratulations. I am so, so, so proud of you. You guys really worked hard, focused. All the projects and writing assignments, the reading, you guys really, really pushed through, and I'm super, super proud of you guys. I know that you're off to bigger and better things in high school. Just make sure that you are working hard, staying focused. Take as many honors and AP classes as you can, earn those college credits. Watch the crowd that you hang around, because that's super important. You want to surround yourself with people who are like-minded and focused just like you. And also, get involved, stay involved, join a sport, join a club, be active at your school, join the SGA, live up to your full potential, explore, see who you really are and what you are fully capable of doing. That's my advice to you moving forward. Again, congratulations. I am so, so proud of you. Keep up all the hard work. Stay focused. And you know where to find me. I'll be at Eliot Hine. So if you have any questions or need a recommendation or anything, feel free to reach out to me. You know where to find me. Again, congratulations, heart. You can add the other half of the heart. But so proud of you guys. Toodles.
Hey, 2020, love and light as always, good vibes only. My heart is full, my heart is heavy. I would love so much to be able to hug each one of you guys' neck and wish you the proper celebratory-ish that you're finishing middle school. But know that everything for a reason, everything for a reason. And be grateful for all. Just please, always stay grateful for all. Know that everything you need is already inside of you. You need to learn how to be able to sit down, shut up, and listen within. That's all you need. That skill will get you far. Along with what I taught you in the art room. Those three R's. Reflect, revise, refine. Always throughout life. Stop and reflect. Think about what you're doing. The outcomes of your thoughts and your words and your actions. Do they serve you? Reflect on that. And then revise. If it's not getting the results that you want, see it differently. Start over. Do it completely different. Speak differently. Think differently. Do different actions. Revise when you need to. And know when to refine. It's good. It's great. But can it be better? What actions, what thoughts, what words could be better that better express yourself and yield a better outcome? I love you. I'm here for you. I'm at Eliot, if you need me. Eliot Hine, if you need me. And the world is yours. Go get it. Love you.
Hi, everyone. It's Miss Maxwell. I just wanted to say congratulations to the class of 2020. Despite the way the year ended, I'm so proud of you guys. I'm so proud of all you've learned in these last 3 years. I'm so proud of all of the Spanish that you guys have acquired and the way that I've seen you grow since the beginning of my time teaching. Obviously, when I started teaching, I was a new teacher alongside you guys. Don't mind my mom, she's just here supporting the video. I was a new teacher when you guys were in the seventh grade, and you guys really made me feel comfortable. You made me feel cared for, and it was wonderful teaching you guys for a little over a year and a half and online. So I wish you the best of luck in your high schools and your endeavors, and know that Eliot Hine is always here to support you.
Hey, great. It's Mr. Van. Wanted to congratulate you on a successful year. I know the past few months haven't been what you guys envisioned, but you guys are resilient and you push through. You're at the finish line. You guys will be freshmen next year. I want to thank you for allowing me to watch you guys grow and mature over the years. You guys will do great and have a successful ninth grade year. Go Eagles.
Ceremony, and I want to take this opportunity to just thank you for a great year. I want to thank you for all of those times that you allowed us into your hearts and into your head to be able to help you push through and persevere through the difficult situations that you would have experienced this year. And as you move into your high school year, I want you to afford others those opportunities to be able to be participants in your process and in your journey. And as you journey forward, I want you to remember that there are great things in you and that you are able to accomplish anything that you set your mind to. I'm looking forward to seeing your faces on newspapers, on TV. I'm looking forward to seeing all of the great things that you will accomplish as you continue on in life. On behalf of the staff and other students of Eliot Hine, I want to congratulate you and wish you all of the best as you continue in life.